Hi guys, welcome to this video about RenderSet. My name is Adam Preisler. I lead the projects team here at Polygonic, doing mostly ArcWiz. And today I would like to show you a case study of a university building that we did here, which is a good example how RenderSet helps us to deliver a lot of content in a short amount of time. Well, first, I would like to show you a little bit what we're dealing with here. So we have a pretty large building with most of the context modeled all around. The scene has 53,000 objects and 162 materials. Memory footprint varies, but let's say if we use 512 to 512 textures, it goes up to around 22 gigabytes. We also did multiple rounds of visualizations, so what you're seeing now is the fourth iteration of the design. Initially, with the client, we were talking about 6 images, but after a while, we offered to render many more views for them, since everything was already in 3D anyway, and they agreed, and later they mentioned that it was very helpful for them to make design decisions, because they see the building with different materials, or from a different angle, or with different light conditions, and that's very helpful. So in the end, you might be asking how many views we actually ended up with. Well, here you can see a little bit for yourself. I'm scrolling through all of them here. We've got interiors, like 10 interiors. We've got lots of exteriors, like 30 exteriors. And we've got 4 aerials and 2 close-ups. So in total, it's about like 46 different renderings. In practice, we are often rendering anywhere from 10 to 40 renders in one go. And RenderSet was the main and, well, basically the only reason we could even do that. And of course, our 4090s. Most of the render contexts have a different camera between each other, but it's not necessarily the only difference between them. Some contexts have different collection visibilities. For example, for some interiors, we turned off the cars and the pedestrians just to save some VRAM. And for example here, in this case, what we could easily do to test 2 versions of the landscape design is to separate the trees into 2 different collections and then set their visibility per each context so that if you change the contexts, the tree type changes as well. So after setting that up, we made sure that we're not having any duplicate objects or anything, and then we simply press the render all button to get our renders, and RenderSet takes care of the rest. So at the end of the day, when everything is properly set up and we're confident that the scene is ready to be rendered, we check all the contexts that need to be done, we pray a little bit, and then we press the render all button. And as you can see, RenderSet simply takes over Blender and goes through all the contexts, renders them out one by one, all the different worlds, all the different cameras, all the different resolutions, and saves them in a folder for us to easily share with the client. In essence, the way this worked in this case was that we just kept on improving the scene during the day according to client feedback, but also of our own accord, because like we want to do a good job, right? And then over the night, we rendered all the different views and we were able to share them with the client the next day in the morning. All in all, without RenderSet, it's really hard to imagine that we would ever do something like this, or we would be able to do something like this in a reasonable time frame. I think we would just be more than happy to do the initial 6 agreed upon renderings and call it a day. But not with RenderSet. So I hope you guys liked the video and you liked the project. We would like to do more of these, maybe. So stay tuned for future videos of this sort.